And
Jai,
it's recorded now. So we're also connected with the devotees from Cologne. Rupa Vilas Prabhu is joining from Cologne, and Jani Thai Prabhu from Berlin, France. I'm not sure from where he's joining. Austria, Vienna. Okay, thank you. And Bhaktin Samira is also joining. She would be here usually. She's from Simhachalam, but she's taking care of her mother. So a few people probably will join in the Zoom. If any of you is not registered yet, please do so. Outside, there's a possibility to register. You can also, there's a possibility to give donations and get some punya. So we're just waiting actually for Akhila Prabhu to come. He will be sitting here. So I'll just shortly explain the setup we have here, and then we will ask Karmakanda Maharaj if you could lead us one more kirtan until Akhila Prabhu arrives, and then we'll start with the scores reading. But I'll shortly explain the setup. So Ananda Krishna Prabhu is our senior, one of the senior most book distributors in Germany, and he will read the scores. He is, expert at this, so he will be reading all the scores, beginning from the bottom up. From Germany, Austria, and Czech. Then we have there, of course, Srila Prabhupada, our founder Acharya. And right next there to Manidhar Prabhu, we have a set of different items that actually Srila Prabhupada used himself when he was visiting Germany. So we have the padukas, the wooden shoes of Srila Prabhupada, we have Tulasi, Maha, and Dhotis. So Manidhar Prabhu, he will take the shoes, original shoes that Srila Prabhupada, Hare Krishna Akhila, herzlich willkommen. Du kannst dich dahin setzen und die Geschenke ausgeben. So Manidhar Prabhu will use those original shoes that Srila Prabhupada used when he was in Germany, in Schloss Rettershof, and bless the devotees who distributed books on their head. Karmakanda Maharaj has the gada, the club of Lord Nisingadev. Very powerful. It destroys all demonic qualities, but it's also a great blessing. And then finally, Akhila Prabhu, we have for the first 15 devotees from Germany, we have some presents also. And there in the middle, we have this wandering trophy, Wanda Trophy. For the devotee who distributed most books over the entire year, they can take this original club and this original Bhagavatam with writing from Srila Prabhupada, handwriting. And on top there is this shatari with the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So that's the trophy. The one who distributed most books over the whole year can take it home for 1 year. Okay. So I will pass on to Ananda Krishna Prabhu. 1 second. And yes, so just for a short sound check. Hare Krishna, you can hear us all in Cologne, Berlin, Austria.
Rivo!
Rivo! Jai. So we can hear you as well. So that's perfect. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. So we will read now the result of the marathon 2021 for devotees distributing in Germany and Austria. It's quite a long list. We have 72 devotees who participated. I will read now just the names of those devotees who distribute up till 100 book points. And every devotee who is now called, please come forward. First, offer your obeisances to Srila Prabhupada, and then you can go through this row and get all your blessings and later on then also presents. Because it's a quite long list, I just mentioned the names. I will not speak too much. And I will not mention the points also for these devotees up till 100 points. That would take too long. From then on, we go a little bit more into detail. Okay. We start with place 72. Amrita Gopi Devidasi, Bhakta Aravinda, So at least I mentioned also the temple. Okay, then yes, those were from Simhachalam. So Krishna Charan, Leipzig. Bhaktin Eva, Simhachalam. Bhakta Stefan, Simhachalam. Bhaktin Asha, Simhachalam. So whenever your name is mentioned, you can come. So maybe they are not here, I don't know. Some are, so many from Simhachalam, so they should come. Okay, dann kommt wahrscheinlich noch. Okay, so then. Nitya Manjari, Goradesh. Bhakta Beshr, Goradesh. Bhakta Edward, Goradesh. Bhakta Kianu, Goradesh. Bhakti Nina from Simhachalam. Then Vini Madhava, Goradesh. Mahaman, Jagannath Temple, Berlin. Krishna Chandra, Navadvip, Heidelberg. Manju Krishna Devidasi from Simhachalam. Bhakta Dimitri, Nürnberg. Is he here? Okay, just because, weil du aus Nürnberg kommst. Sehr gut. Bhaktin Tatjana, Nürnberg. Kishori Kun, Simhachalam. Jagat Vasu, Wien. Namamrita, Nürnberg. Damayanti, Goradesh, Köln. Haribo. Bhaktin Tetiana, Offenbach, Frankfurt am Main. Chaini Taitas, Berlin. Haribo. Bhaktin Larissa aus Nürnberg. Bhaktin Julia, Simhachalam. Ist niemand hier? Ja. Ist ja alle am Kochen oder so, ich weiß nicht. Oder schlafen, ja. Dann Heiko Krack, Harinamadesh, Wiesbaden. Nandi Mukhi Devidasi, Simhachalam. Bhaktin Vera, Nürnberg. Bhakta Paul, Jagannath Tempel, Berlin. Vajendra Kumar, Golokadam. Aber jetzt, wenn der jetzt nicht da ist. Rajachana aus Wien. Arivol, der Erste. Sehr gut, sehr gut. Chai. Rajachan hat verteilt 28 Buchpunkte. Hm? 28 Buchpunkte. So, dann Bhaktin Ludmila, Nürnberg. Bhakta Karl, Nürnberg. Bhakta Selim, Goradesh, Köln. Kommt auch noch. Gopi Gita Devidasi, Simhachalam. Das Feedback? So, wir sind jetzt bei 52 Punkten. Wir haben noch 5 Devotees und dann kommen wir unter die zu den 100. Dara Devidasi, Goradesh, Köln. Bhakta Franz aus Wien. Narahari Devidasi aus Simhachalam. Gerade. Ja, ich meine, ich lese die Liste vor, das andere kann ich nicht herbeizaubern. Lilamrita Devidasi aus Goradesh. Und dann haben wir Kanjani Devidasi aus Goradesh. Aber wenn der jetzt nicht da ist. Govinda Dev aus Simhachalam. Ah, da ist er ja, sehr gut. Mit 72 Buchpunkten. So, aus Leipzig, Mitravinda Devidasi. 77 Buchpunkte. Die habe ich auch vorher gerade noch gesehen. Sind also demütig, die Devotis, ja, wenn nicht kommen. Dann Bhakta Mehul aus Nürnberg. So, Platz Nummer 29, Sanjay mit 84 Buchpunkten. Platz 28, Bhakta Leo aus Govardhandesh. Platz 27, Keshi Nishurana, 97 Buchpunkte. So, und ab jetzt über 100 Buchpunkte, die letzten 26 Plätze. Bhaktin Olga aus Nürnberg. Halada aus Govardhan Desh, Bad Oeynhausen. Platz 24, Gaur Mohan aus dem Hachalam mit 146 Buchpunkten. Platz 23, Bhakta Moses aus dem Hachalam mit 157 Buchpunkten. Tja, da ist er ja, sehr gut. Erst Ehrerbietungen. Prabhupada, genau. Wenn ihr vorkommt, das ist jetzt so selten gewesen, sonst haben wir noch keine Beispiele. Erst Ehrerbietungen Prabhupada und dann durch die Reihe der. Insgesamt war es ein sehr erfolgreicher Marathon. Sehr viele Bücher sind verteilt worden. Viele Devotis waren draußen, also haben sich nicht stoppen lassen von den einschüchternden Umständen, die meistens nur in der Zeitung stehen. Nichts mit der Realität zu tun haben.
Die hat auch verteilt.
Wer?
Den Shire.
Okay.
Die waren unter den ersten 100.
Und wie viel ist hier?
Also,
sie hier?
Ja. Okay. Man, sie wurde nicht.
Dann haben wir noch einen Bhaktin Chaya. Sie wurde nicht erwähnt, aber hat auch verteilt. Bhaktin Chaya hat. Wo ist sie? Haribol! Haribol! Du hast auch verteilt. Okay. Oh, in the teams? No problem. Okay, you can. Still. Narahari Mataji Ki Chai. Dann, wo war ich stehen geblieben? Ekayani Devidasi aus Goradesh, Köln. Mit 157 Buchpunkten. Platz 21, Manjulamani Devidasi mit 158 Buchpunkten aus Golokadam. Platz 20, Vraj Tilak, Goradesh, 168 Buchpunkte. Platz 19, Bhakta Moritz, Goradesh, 136 Buchpunkte. Platz Nummer 18, Nila Madhava mit 192 Buchpunkten aus Goradesh. Platz Nummer 17, mit 229 Buchpunkten aus dem Hachalam, Advaita Simha Das. Haribo! Ja, ich war mit Advaita ein paar Tage verteilen. Wir waren in Regensburg, wir waren in Passau und wir waren in Straubing. Ja, wir waren so die Weekend Warriors. Ab und zu haben wir es geschafft. Und danke, dass wir das zusammen machen konnten. Dass wir wenigstens ein bisschen teilnehmen konnten am Marathon. Und das war sehr inspirierend, auf jeden Fall. Und gleichzeitig ist Advaita Simha hier ja auch im Management und in der Küche, hat viele Dienste, wohnt hier in Simhachal mit seiner Familie, ist ein begieriger Buchverteiler. So, Platz Nummer 16, Govinda Kund aus Golokadam mit 232 Buchpunkten. Haribol. Platz 15 aus dem Hachala mit 248 Buchpunkten, Bhakta Bajar. Also Bashar und Advaita, wir waren zu dritt und waren ein paar Mal draußen Bücher verteilen. Bashar ist auch der Tempelkommander hier aus dem Hachalam und gleichzeitig sehr, sehr begierig, Bücher zu verteilen, weil er sehr früh, als er Devote geworden ist hier in Deutschland, mit Paramatma Krishna Gemeinschaft gehabt hat. So, wer mit Paramatma Gemeinschaft hat, der muss dann auch Bücher verteilen. Und das ist auch gut so. Und Bashar ist sehr inspiriert, das zu tun. Ja. Und wie gesagt, wir waren in ein paar Städten hier. Nichts passiert. Ja. Genau. Wir hoffen, dass er auch, obwohl er so viel hier zu tun hat, noch mehr verteilen kann dieses Jahr. Dann Platz Nummer 14, Advaita Gora Hari mit 256 Buchpunkten. Platz Nummer 13, Bhakta Niklas, 345 Buchpunkte aus Goradesh, Köln. So, und jetzt, okay, fast schon in den Top 10. Ich habe es fast in die Top 10 geschafft. Schade, naja. Gut, meine Wenigkeit mit 404 Buchpunkten, aber ich muss dazu sagen, das war nicht nur auf der Straße, sondern auch ein bisschen was online. Gut, bin ich auf Platz 12, naja. Thank you. Gut, dann geht's weiter. Platz Nummer 11 aus dem Hatschalam, einer unserer neuen Sankirtan-Devotis, der den ganzen Marathon unterwegs war. Und er hat verteilt insgesamt über 1000 Bücher, 1134 Bücher für 615 Buchpunkten. Bhakta Vito. Haribol! Ja, wie gesagt, Bhakta Vito ist einer unserer neuen Sankirtan-Devotis, ein sehr freundlicher Devoti, immer am Lächeln, immer freundliche Worte, und ich kann mir vorstellen, dass er auf der Straße das auch sehr gut kommuniziert, und er ist nur noch sehr begierig, Bücher zu verteilen, worüber wir sehr froh sind, weil es sehr schwierig das zu tun und überhaupt, dass das jemand Vollzeit machen möchte. Und dadurch sind wir eben, wie gesagt, froh, dass der Sankirtan erhalten bleibt. Ja, nach so vielen Generationen ist es immer schön zu sehen, wenn neue wieder dazukommen und eben der Sankirtan nicht ausstirbt. Und ich denke, daran haben wir alle Interesse, dass wir diese Tätigkeit weitergeben dürfen. Insgesamt muss ich sagen, dass dieses Jahr ganz viele neue Sankirtan-Devotis draußen waren, auch aus der Gemeinde, auch ja, unerwartet eigentlich. Und grundsätzlich sehe ich, dass in Deutschland der Sankirtan noch immer lebt und eigentlich eine gute Zukunft vor sich hat. So, dann auf Platz Nummer 10 aus dem Hatschalam mit 823 Büchern, 865 Buchpunkte, Bhaktin Samira. Haribol! So, Bhaktin Samira ist online, glaube ich, dabei, guckt zu, und war mit Krishna Bhumi auf Traveling Sankirtan. Sie haben ein kleines Wohnmobil und waren damit reisend unterwegs in Deutschland und Österreich auch, ne? Nur Österreich. Obwohl in Österreich vor dem Marathon gesagt wurde, es ist total Lockdown. Aber sind trotzdem hingegangen, haben sehr, sehr viele Bücher verteilt, auch auf verschiedenen Corona-Demonstrationen. Ja, haben sie nicht teilgenommen, aber Bücher dort verteilt. Und auch eine unserer aufstrebenden neuen Sankirtan-Devotis. Dann auf Platz 9 mit 1005 Büchern, 919 Buchpunkten, Krishna Bhumi Devidasi aus Wien. Chai. Das war knapp, ja? Habt ihr einen ganz schönen Battle hier gehabt, oder? Also Punkte war der Unterschied so 50 Punkte. Also so ein halber Tag Buchverteilung, ne? Hätte gereicht. Hm? Wahrscheinlich ganz schön intensive Stimmung da in dem Wohnmobil. Und das ist auch gut so. Prabhupada wollte das auch, dass es ein bisschen Wettkampf-Spirit gibt zwischen den Sankirtan-Devotis, sich gegenseitig zu inspirieren. Okay. Dann Platz Nummer 8 mit 968 Büchern und 1064 Punkten aus dem Hatschalam Bhakta Björn. Haribol! Ja, das ist einer unserer ganz neuen Sankirtan-Devotis, Bhakta Björn. Sehr, sehr vorbildlicher Brahmachari auch, wie ihr seht, er ist in Safran, also er lebt als Brahmachari, als Mönch und nimmt das sehr ernst in seinem Studium, in seiner Demo, Dienstbereitschaft und eben auch, indem er Bücher verteilt. War zusammen mit Kripa Sindhu, ne? Kripa Sindhu auf Sankirtan, ja. Gut, dann Platz Nummer 7 aus Goloka Dham mit 1425 Büchern, 1379 Buchpunkten, Advitya Baladev. Platz Nummer 6 mit 823 Büchern, 1579 Buchpunkte, Dana Keli Devidasi. Haribol! Chai, Dana Keli ist auch hier. Aus München, hauptsächlich in München und um München herum Bücher verteilt. Und überall, ja. Auch in Ägypten, zwischendurch mal schnell nach Ägypten, auch ein paar Bücher verteilt. Ja, wie gesagt, überall, ne? Wahnsinn, so viele Bücher verteilt. So, Platz Nummer 5 aus Goradesh, Köln. Rupa Vilas das mit 715 Büchern, 1634 Buchpunkten. Haribol! Ist leider nicht hier, aber online sind sie dabei und schauen zu. So, nun kommen wir schon zu den Top 4. Stimmt doch nicht. Was ist das für eine Liste? Stimmt das?
Ja.
Okay, das ist überraschend. Auf Platz Nummer 4 mit 1334 Büchern und 2334 Buchpunkten aus dem Hatschalam Kripasindhu Haribol Chai. Sehr nice. Kripasindhu ist ein langjähriger Buchverteiler und nicht nur irgendein Buchverteiler, sondern Vollzeitbuchverteiler. Das ganze Jahr draußen, schon seit, weiß nicht, 10 Jahren oder so. Ja, korrigiere mich, wenn es falsch ist. Muss man sich mal vorstellen, 10 Jahre lang eigentlich jeden Tag Bücher verteilen. Das ist schon krass. Das ist schon krass. Und er nimmt das sehr, sehr ernst und hat diesen Marathon auch eine neue Arbeit in einer neuen Strategie, um mehr Bücher zu verteilen, indem er jedem mehr Bücher gibt. Und er hat sich kleine Sets vorbereitet mit Schlaufe drum, ja, und als kleines Geschenk. Und wie viele Bücher waren da drin in dem Set? Manchmal 4, 5 Bücher auf einmal. So, ja. Und hat sehr viele Leute getroffen, die so viele Bücher auf einmal genommen haben. Nach dem Vorbild eines Devotees, wie hieß er nochmal? Mahotsaha, ja, Mahotsaha Prabhu, der gerade einen gigantischen Rekord aufgestellt hat in Amerika und über 1400 Bücher an einem Tag verteilt hat. So, und der hat das eben so gemacht, ne? 7 Bücher auf einmal. So, Kripasindhu versucht das zu perfektionieren, um diesen Rekord zu brechen. Und er ist auch zu Tür gegangen, weil manchmal war er in neuen Städten, in denen nicht viel los war, ja, in der Schweiz, und da habe ich gesagt, okay, dann gehe ich Tür zu Tür. Und das, ja, das ist sehr wichtig, diese Innovation, dieser Mut für was Neues auszuprobieren. Ja, Chai. So, nun die Top 3, auf Platz 3, auch aus dem Hatschalam, mit 2002 Büchern für 2363 Buchpunkte. Munindra Gana Prabhu Haribo! So. Und Munindra Gana ist unser zweiter Sankirtan-Leader hier neben Kripasindhu. Und der auch schon seit vielen Jahren, auch seit 10 Jahren oder so, rausgeht. Und ich bewundere die beiden für ihre Entschlossenheit und ihre Geduld, so viele Jahre das zu tun und auch neuen Devotees das zu zeigen und weiterhin enthusiastisch zu sein und inspiriert zu sein. Also sie wollen noch immer weiter Bücher verteilen und auch dieses Jahr diesen Dienst tun. Und das machen sie nicht aus, weil sie gewinnen wollen oder Punkte oder so, sondern weil sie dieses Pflichtbewusstsein haben und das ernst nehmen und Freude erfahren in diesem Dienst. Und da sind wir sehr froh, dass wir sie hier haben und dass sie eben den neuen Devotees das zeigen. Danke euch. So, nun auf Platz 2 eine Dame, Buchverteiler-Dame, ganz neu eigentlich. Sie verteilt schon seit 2 Jahren oder so ungefähr die Bücher, aber jetzt auf einmal total durchgestartet, direkt im Marathon auf Platz 2. Und wir hoffen und wünschen ihr, dass sie weiterhin so inspiriert bleibt. Aus Nürnberg mit 1472 Büchern und 2515 Buchpunkten, Bhaktin Antonia. Haribo! Und sie hat 3 Kinder. Ach so, die haben mitverteilt, deshalb, ja, zu viert. Ja, 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 ja. Sehr gute Taktik. Ja, ja, klar. Ja, jedenfalls. Das ist, was ich vorher gemeint habe. Ja, im deutschen Yatra haben wir jetzt ein paar neue, also einige ganz neue Devotees, die diese Mission von Srila Prabhupada ernst nehmen und umsetzen. Und so können wir hoffnungsvoll in die Zukunft blicken und hoffen, dass sich das noch erweitert. Ja. Und auf Platz 1, das hat Tradition, daran wird nicht gerüttelt, das wird sich niemals ändern wahrscheinlich. Das ist ewig wie Goloka Vrindavan, ewig wie das Krishna, die höchste Persönlichkeit Gottes ist. So ist ewiglich dieser Devotee auf Platz 1. Das hat er, den Platz hat er sich reserviert oder ich weiß nicht. Also das ist auch unmöglich, dass irgendjemand das mal macht. Also ich lese mal alles vor. Also kleine Bücher. 964, Medium-Bücher 325, Big-Bücher 710 und Maha-Bücher, also Bhagavad-Gitas, 1775 und ein Bhagavatam-Set. Zusammen sind das 3775 Bücher für 6042 Buchpunkte. Paramatma Krishna Prabhu Ke Jai. Hari Bol, 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 Hari Bol. Ja, also ich lese meistens Diskurs vor, also das ist, was ich mache, und Paramatma gewinnt den Marathon jedes Jahr. Jeder hat so sein Nitya Dharma, so, ne? Also irgendwas, was man halt ewiglich tut. Paramatma gewinnt den Marathon, ne? Das Swarup sozusagen. Und ich, ja, frage mich, ob das jemals jemand mehr verteilen kann. Ich glaube, Kripa Sindhu hat es so die ersten zwei Wochen probiert und war ein bisschen dran, ne? Aber dann Paramatma, glaube ich, gesagt, naja, jetzt fange ich an zum Bücher verteilen. Hat Gas gegeben und dann gesagt, okay, gewinne ich mal wieder. So, danke schön. Paramatma Krishna Prabhu Ki. Dann haben wir hier noch Teamverteilung. Ich weiß nicht, ich erwähne das auch. 9 Teams hatten wir. Das heißt, da waren mehrere Devotees zusammen verteilen. Auch aus Simhachalam haben wir einen Buchtisch. Dann das tägliche Bhagavatam, Gorni Times. Das ist sind Devotees, die jeden Tag einen Livestream haben und lesen aus dem Bhagavatam. Da haben sie auch ein paar Bücher drüber verteilt. Dann hatten wir ein Team ISKCON Wien. Und dann hatten wir ein Team aus Wisdom Wednesday. Das sind auch Devotees, die einen Livestream haben und so als Team verteilt haben. Dann haben wir noch Veda Weisheit. Das ist der Online-Shop von Govindadev. Und dann haben wir Bhaktin Chaya. Ah, da war die Teamverteilung. Gut, sie war vorher schon da. Und dann noch aus Heidelberg und aus Harinamadesh. Und Achyuta Nimai steht hier, gilt auch als Team. Er ist ein Team. Gut, so nun die Ergebnisse der Yatras. Also welcher Tempel hat in diesem Marathon am meisten Bücher verteilt? Wir haben 13 Tempel. Platz 13, Gorni Times, Liebenau. Platz 12, Berlin. Platz 11, Leipzig, ja, Haribol. Platz 10, Bad Oeynhausen, Govardhandesh. Platz 9, Wiesbaden, mit 120 Büchern. Platz 8, Frankfurt, 36 Bücher. Platz 7, Heidelberg, 58 Bücher. Auf Platz 6, Wien, 1122 Bücher, Haribol. Platz 5, Goloka Dham, 1810 Bücher. Platz 4, Nürnberg, 1693 Bücher, Haribol. Platz 3, Boradesh, Köln, 1932 Bücher. Auf Platz 2, ISKCON München, 4598 Bücher. Und Platz 1, Simhachalam Dham, mit 7604 Bücher, Haribol. Okay. Ja, schon 3000 Bücher. Ja. Gut. Das war die Marathonliste. Und dann möchte ich die ersten, das schauen wir mal ganz kurz, ersten drei, das ist die Jahresliste, das ist auch wichtig. Und dafür gibt es ja auch einen Pokal. Wer hat im ganzen Jahr am meisten verteilt? Ich lese vielleicht da die ersten 10 vor. Wo ist die Liste jetzt? Ja, hier. Okay. Oh, Platz 10. Ananda Krishna Das. Jai. Ich war auch dabei. Mit 2009 Punkten. Platz 9, Dana Keli. 2252 Punkte. Haribo. Platz 8, Advitya Baladev. 2300 Punkte. Haribo. Auf Platz 7 Punkte. Rupa Vilas Das mit 2412 Punkten. Auf Platz 6 Bhakta Björn 3567 Punkte. Haribol. Platz 5 Lilamrita Devidasi 4093 Punkte. Auf Platz 4 Bhaktin Antonia 4571 Punkte. Auf Platz 3 mit 5.399 Punkten Munindra Gana. Auf Platz 2 mit 7.279 Punkten Kripa Sindhu. Und auf Platz 1 mit 13.169 Buchpunkte in Paramatma Krishna Prabhu Ki Jai. Hari Bol. Okay, Paramatma hat den Marathon gewonnen und auch im ganzen Jahr am meisten Bücher verteilt. Hari Bol. Und dann noch wenigstens die ersten drei Tempel. Welche Tempel haben das ganze Jahr am meisten verteilt? Soll auch Inspiration dann sein für die anderen Tempel, also dass man das auch betont. Ja, nicht nur die Individuen, sondern auch die Tempelgemeinschaften, sodass dort auch organisierter Bücher verteilt werden kann. So lese ich alle vor, 15 Tempel. Auf Platz 15 Zürich, auf Platz 14 Liebenau, Platz 13 Hamburg, Platz 12 Leipzig, Platz 11 Frankfurt, Platz 10 Bad Oeynhausen, Platz 9 Berlin, Platz 8 Wiesbaden, Platz 7 Heidelberg, Platz 6 Wien mit 2253 Buchpunkten, Platz 5 Goloka Dham 5589 Buchpunkte, Platz 4 Nürnberg 6154 Buchpunkte, Platz 3 Gorodetsch Köln 12768 Buchpunkte, Platz 2 ISKCON München mit 15422 Buchpunkten und Platz 1 Simhachalam da mit 23522 Buchpunkten. Haribo. Wir haben jetzt leider kein Total auf der Liste, das ist sehr schade. Weil normal ist auch wichtig zu wissen, wie viel das ganze deutsche, ne, das habe ich hier, Entschuldigung, doch, das habe ich hier. Das ganze deutsche Yatra hat im Jahr 2021, haben wir zusammen verteilt in ganz Deutschland 50.949 Bücher für 68.945 Buchpunkte. Haribo! Haribo. Und dann kommt noch Österreich dazu. In Österreich wurden auch fast 2000 Bücher verteilt für 2200 Buchpunkte. Und das heißt, zusammen haben wir ein bisschen über 70.000 Buchpunkte gemacht dieses Jahr. So, das ist sehr gut, ja. Für dieses Jahr auf jeden Fall sehr gut. Und vielleicht schaffen wir mal wieder 100.000 Buchpunkte. Ist nicht so unmöglich. Hare Krishna. So, danke schön. Das waren die Ergebnisse. Ich wurde gebeten, auch die Ergebnisse von Tschechien vorzulesen, aber da lese ich nur die ersten 10 vor, weil die haben auch eine sehr lange Liste. Die haben also so viele, die haben 200 Devotees haben dort Bücher verteilt. 200 Devotees haben hier das ganze Jahr, das war das ganze Jahr, 200 Devotees und im Marathon auch 136, ja, wir hatten ein bisschen über 70, doppelt so viele Devotees draußen. Und ja, ich lese einfach die ersten drei vor. Auf Platz 3, Madhusudan Das hat verteilt 900 Bücher, 1189 Buchpunkte. Haribo. Dann auf Platz 2, Rajendranath Das aus Lutsche. Okay. 1175 Bücher, 1386 Buchpunkte. Haribo. Und auf Platz 1 aus Prabhupada Bhavan, Sankirtan Das, der hat verteilt 1905 Bücher und 2094 Buchpunkte. Haribo. Das ist auch eine Tradition dort. Ne? Gewinnt auch immer Sankirtan Das. Der gewinnt auch dort immer den Marathon. Und das ganze Jahr haben sie verteilt in Tschechien, das ist auch eine wichtige Zahl, im ganzen Jahr wurden verteilt 47.000 Bücher für 54.515 Buchpunkte. Hare Krishna. Gut, okay, das waren die Ergebnisse, die ich vorlesen wollte. Sollte. Danke vielmals. Es ging ein bisschen schnell, aber ist auch kein Problem. Die Votis können sich nachher noch ihre Preise abholen und vielleicht bitten wir unsere Gäste und Senior Devotees noch ein paar abschließende Worte zu sprechen über den Marathon.
The one thing that gave Srila Prabhupada extraordinary pleasure was undoubtedly the distribution of his books. Hmm. It was astonishing to see how much his divine grace became enthusiastic, even when his health was not good, to hear about the results of book distribution was something that was just very close to his heart. His spiritual master instructed him when he met him at Radhakund. He told him not to focus on constructing temples, but he said, if you ever have money, print books. Srila Prabhupada made this book publication and book production the foundation of his entire movement. His spiritual master had mentioned that the mridanga, he said, how far will the sound of the mridanga reach? But the brihat mridanga, the sound of the printing press, and the printing press, as it was traditionally made, had an arm that moved and would make the sound of beating. Boom. Even today in Bengal, they still have such old-fashioned printing presses, and it's still like boom, the BBT in Mayapur. So in this way, that beating of the press, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta compared it to the Brihat Mridanga, the great Mridanga, the Mridanga that could be heard all over the world. There is no doubt that the world will change by the distribution of these books. Sometimes one wonders, so many books distributed, more than 500 million books distributed worldwide up to today. But where are all the devotees? The books are penetrating into people's lives. The books are reaching so many people. I remember myself that I never bought a book on the street, because in those days, the devotees would wear wigs, and I could see, uh-oh, that's a guy with a wig, watch out. So I avoided them. So I never bought a book on the street. They never stopped me. But I just got it from the bookshelf of a friend. I just said, can I borrow that book? And he said, oh, you can have it. I never read it. But he read it before. Then it came to me. I read it. Now that Bhagavad Gita is no longer with me. I don't know where it went. I can't remember. But somebody must have gotten that Bhagavad Gita. So how many people are reading just one book? Even one book can make an entire journey and touch the lives of many. We may think, yeah, but people are not surrendering. Don't worry. There is the ancient story of the sparrow. The sparrow that had lost its eggs to the ocean. The sparrow stood before the ocean and said, return those eggs or I will drink your water. The ocean was not impressed, never bothered to reply. But Garuda, his heart melted, and Garuda came, and Garuda stood before the ocean and said, now return those eggs or I'll drink your water. Then the ocean, yes, Mr. Garuda, of course, Mr. Garuda. Eggs, you said, Mr. Garuda? Yes, here they are, of course. Anything else, Mr. Garuda? So in the same way, our efforts may look insignificant in one way when we look at the world population, when we look at how many people we need to reach. At this pace, will we ever do it? But that is not how it works. We distribute the books, and Krishna will do the rest. Krishna will be attracted, and Krishna can change the world. We saw the miracle that happened in the former Soviet Union. Right? I never believed it, that it could happen. The Soviet Union looked like it was the Iron Curtain. It was going to be closed forever. We never thought that all these devotees would get out of jail. We never thought that now so many books have been distributed in Russia, and that there are more Russian devotees than of practically any other nationality. That was nothing short but a miracle. So miracles are happening. Miracles are happening in this book distribution. We are never alone. Krishna is present, personally present on the street. And that makes this book distribution the most amazing thing, that Krishna is there on the street and one can meet him. This is why Sankirtan devotees come back after the marathon and they are shining. They're effulgent. This is why they're joyful, why they call out Jai when it's Nuremberg or whatever, Haribo, because there is some magic there. It is Krishna who's providing this magic. People take when they were not expected to take them. Sometimes someone is really not interested and suddenly their mood changes. They take, we see Krishna intervened. On the street, we meet Krishna. On the street, this Sangatan is the life of transcendental knowledge. We are experiencing very much that we're living on the cutting edge of Krishna consciousness, that we are there with Krishna. And as such, it is the most wonderful service. And the Sankirtan devotees are blessed, undoubtedly. They think of the welfare of others. And just like it is said in the seventh canto of Bhagavatam, if you decorate your face, then automatically the face in the mirror is also decorated. If we think of the welfare of others by giving them Krishna, then we become decorated by that service. And so it is a service where we can make a lot of advancement. So we're very happy with the long-term commitment of devotees. Those who did the marathon, we are happy with those who went out for a day. We're happy with those who went out for a week. We're happy with those who went out for the entire month. We are even more impressed by those who went out for the entire year. And for those who went out for 10 years or more, for those who continue to go out, they are certainly the most fortunate. Yes, as age goes by, we may distribute some books on the internet. Like me nowadays, I distribute books from the Vyasa Sangha. Yeah. I did in the marathon. It's like I was on the Czech score sheet. Should be, but because I did it in Czech, because we want to somehow or other be part of this amazing movement, the Sankirtan movement of Lord Chaitanya, which is changing the entire world. And to be able to be part of that is the greatest blessing. That opportunity is there, and those who partake are most fortunate. Param vijayate Shri Krishna Sankirtanam ki jai.
Well, the most essential thing we already said, but I would like to actually pick up on this point, which I heard occasionally through the last 40 years coming up again and again, and you will hear this again. How is it possible? Books being distributed, and why is not there really more result there? And personally, I never took part in these discussions. We had a simple life, a simple instruction. Prabhupada wanted these books being distributed, and that's period. Like, not like, appreciated, not appreciated. They asked us in a German police station who organized this collection here. So either we showed them picture of Lord Nishingadev, or sometimes when they were a little bit more nicer, then we showed them a picture of Prabhupada. How many people actually I met in Germany alone on the street? You will not believe it. Simple people. I remember this one man. He said, I don't understand your books. I got some. I don't read this Chinese, or, you know, because for a normal person, open book like this is not a book he expects. I mean, this is Sanskrit, and word by word, he doesn't know how it's connected. Then comes purport. And then comes a shloka, which is containing words which we never use in a daily language. I remember myself, first time opening Bhagavad Gita, reading about fruitive activities. I immediately thought about apples, bananas, and, you know, and this. I said, what kind of book is this? And actually, I wasn't alone. The first Czech translation of the more underground printed already Bhagavad Gita, the translator didn't know either. In Czech, it's a very colorful language. So you can translate the word with fruitive, really, like with fruitive, you know, with apple and banana and grapes and anything. So I was thinking, what is this? And then somebody explained, no, this is the activities which bring some result, some fruit. Oh, then, or getting purified. It was for me, purified from what? I washed my hands. What is the big thing? What are they writing about this purification? I remember this whole vocabulary. We never use these kind of things. So no wonder when people open the book. But this man, he said, no, I don't understand this. Just imagine, they get nectar out of the ocean. Oh my God. Describing the, you know, how big is the genital of God or whatever. Oh, impossible. So then, you know, but he said, one book I read from the beginning to the end. He said, and that was about your guru. He said, and I cried. What a man. But he has gone through. And I looked at him and he said, and he did it. So just you can get more books. You want more books? And actually he bought some books more. And I said, this is the books you will like and not understand simultaneously. It doesn't matter. And he smiled. He said, it's okay. So he was caught just by Prabhupada's life. And actually it is Prabhupada. That's the reason why we are distributing these books, because of him. It was not my idea. I didn't write them. I didn't print them. I never pictured myself standing on a street even selling anything. What to speak of these books? You know, it's completely against my design. I used to be a very shy boy sitting at home and trying to be intellectual. And then I was on a street in Germany, you know, this vocabulary, you know, yeah, well, Verschwender. Nah. Yeah, so this, and you get all the time this really gross, and I went in Germany through times, the younger devotees don't know that, and I hope you will never experience that. You get out of the Sankirtan van, comes a simple lady, German, going shopping, seeing you, she gripped me. I got him, I got him! Police! So if it would be a man, I would punch him. But it was a woman, so I just stood there, police came, and they asked, what has he done? Well, nothing. But it was in the Bild-Zeitung, in the newspaper, when you see them, catch them. and call police. This was the atmosphere we used to describe. I think Akila may understand, still remember that. Getting beaten by the umbrellas, you know, just. I remember once I stood in a city called Rotweil on a street distributing book, and suddenly somebody got my Sika from behind and was going and cut most of it off. And she said, "That has to be going off." It was a lady with a scissors. You know, it was like this. I mean, it was very common. We were just like, you know, like hunting. It was a hunting season on Hare Krishna, you know. So, but we didn't mind because we knew one thing. Prabhupada wants this book's going out. You know, and you really, when you go on Sangitan, you meet people you doubt they can read at all. Or you speak some books. I came once to the culture center of Germany, Ruhrgebiet, Bottrop. You know, there is no difference between the buildings, it's just one factory going into the other. And people who come out of these factories, they look like part of some equipment of the factories. You know, they just come out and they go, So I was going, hello, you know, take a book. And they were like, So I was desperate. I was going, so I just turned around, I got fed out, and I was going, hello, do you know how to read? And the man was going, yeah. So take it.
Yeah.
You have money?
Yeah.
Then give it. I mean, you go like this the whole day, you feel like, my God, I mean, distributing to sheep would be more easy. But there are, you will not believe it, but there are places like that. People are so covered. And then you wonder, what have they done to these people? And even out of these people, you may get people who suddenly lighten up. And actually, they become devotees. You know? I saw in Germany people joining, they couldn't remember even their own name. Those days. Nowadays, the standards are much higher, but those days, I mean, you know, they told me, take this bhakta out and don't bring him back. Really foul people. Sometimes I was driving a car in a bag, there was two bhaktas. They were already informed about Krishna consciousness. So suddenly I look in a mirror and they were just beating each other. He said, I'm not a pure devotee. Dung! This was the, you know, there was the people who were going out distributing books. I mean, this yatra went through so many phases of Sangitan, you cannot imagine what kind of individuals were walking in Germany in the street distributing books. But they had all one thing in common. They're very dedicated to Prabhupada. I don't want to go in details now. You may not believe me. Such a persons we don't find today hardly anymore. Either actually, and if they would be find them, there will be immediate objection, you know. You maybe remember some names till you heard something from the past. Boy, we had once upon a time a Sangitan leader here. He could beat up a whole police station. This was an amazing person. It was getting so bad, we split the Sangitan in two departments. The Govinda League, that was me, and the Nishinga League, that was him. The Nishinga League actually had to, at the end, leave Germany. They had so many police cases, you cannot imagine. And Govinda League, we were the bhaktas and the softies, they call us the softies. So we kept on just distributing. Now, from today's point of view, it sounds really bizarre. But I tell you quite frankly, I saw this man, he could do 600 books in one day. I distributed sometimes close by in another town. People came in the town driving cars like this. And when I offered them a book, they were going, I met your friend in the last town. I look at the back seat, there was 6 Krishna books, part one. You know. This man had mantras, you cannot imagine. Hello, do you know karate? No, I do. Take this. I mean, cannot imagine. I couldn't believe what I'm hearing. I saw all these devotees dancing in front of Srila Prabhupada in Bhaktivedanta manner. Prabhupada was totally aware. Because he was always, you know, for a little while, he was on the top of the list. So Prabhupada was sitting in a kirtan, as you know, the last visit of Prabhupada in Bhaktivedanta manner, Prabhupada was in a very, very difficult condition. So he was placed, carried on the Vyasasan, as he was mentioned by Kadamakana Maharaj before, during the Guru Puja. It was very tense atmosphere because we all didn't want to know it, but we knew we are seeing Prabhupada last time. So it was very tense. In Prabhupada, the Guru Puja started with this, you know, Sri Guru Charana. Prabhupada looked like on a cyclist, and he made this with the hand. And then actually he opened the hands and was going. And as he did it, the Medangas were already on the ceiling. And became ferocious kirtan. Bhaktivedanta Manor is not such a big temple. It was completely packed, you know. And I remember that kirtan was incredible. There was ladies in the back, those days, ladies are in the back. There was a very old lady. She must have been, I mean, really old. She brought for the Guru Puja Prabhupada this big bucket of lilies, this big white lilies, to bring it to him on the Vyasasan. But she never made it to the Vyasasan because there was no way devotees could circumambulate and offer flowers because everybody was on the ceiling, just jumping, you know. And Prabhupada liked it hot. So I suddenly looked and I couldn't believe it. The lady was in a corner. She was also on a ceiling, jumping 1.5 meter high. Hey, ba! I couldn't believe it. I was going, what? Never saw in that age an old woman jumping that high. And she had this, still this lily. She was clinching to them. So she realized she cannot make it. So she took it with an incredible force, just threw it over the heads of the devotees directing Prabhupada. And devotees were catching these lilies and actually transporting them all practically to Prabhupada. Prabhupada liked that. And who was the worst of the whole thing? Our German Sankirtan leader. Some man who liked to dance half naked in a kirtan so you can see the muscles coming up. And I saw him going through the devotees. Devotees flying here and there, and he worked himself in front of Prabhupada. He looked actually very, I don't want to insult anybody's anatomy, but he looked very German. It's just the helmet missing, you know, here just.
Sturmführer.
So, you know, and he looked like that. And I was standing to like 45 degree to Prabhupada. I looked at Prabhupada's face. He noticed him, of course. So he was like working himself towards Prabhupada, who had heavy kirtan. Prabhupada looked, and his face suddenly hardened, very heavy. Practically, I copied the face of the devotee. His chin came out like this, and he was going, very good German quality. The man was going on a ceiling. Because he felt so understood. Prabhupada likes my German quality. Yeah, well, what happened then after, that's another story, but Prabhupada was amazing. He didn't compromise the covering of our body. He just purified it, you know. So the best of a man and the best of a nation and the best what we can do came out in presence of Prabhupada. And the other qualities, they were also there. We all have a little bit, I think everybody has some other qualities also, not just the good ones. But that was like neutralized. And Prabhupada said that. And when you come on Sankirtan, that's where the best qualities of the man are coming. Unbelievable. I saw devotees, even in a temple, you know. We used to call them the dive bombers, you know. You touch him and he explodes.
Prabhu, don't disturb my chanting, I'm meditating.
Because the first thing which wakes up is the false ego. Same person on Sankirtan, it's just an angel. It's so beautiful to see devotees going on Sankirtan, distributing books, coming back from Sankirtan, just angels. Prabhupada used to call it man from Vaikuntha. One marathon, devotees got so ecstatic, they said, Prabhupada, this is so ecstatic. We really are feeling we are increasing our desire to go back home, back to Godhead, actually to go to Vaikuntha. You know what Prabhupada answered? He wrote back, you don't have to plan or desire that, you are already there. So this is what happens. So if somebody wants to be really happy and experience something he never experienced before, himself, that's you, the soul, eternal part of Krishna, under the guidance of a pure devotee, you can be yourself. That's you in Sankirtan. It's a wonderful thing. So I don't want to prolong this moment, but it's really blessed souls who go out there, who can do this service and who can come back and bless others by dint of the inspiration they get by doing that kind of service. Sankirtan ki jai.
Hare Krishna, Maharaj said dear. Actually, those devotees who are distributing the books, they could deliver the real nectar. What came to my mind is that when I was visiting my parents and I had the Gita with me, in the introduction, I read, without Krishna consciousness, the life is spoiled. Ohne Krishna Bewusstsein ist das Leben verdorben. So that changed the direction of my life. That really had an input on my consciousness. Without Krishna consciousness, the life is spoiled. So either or, you want to live a spoiled, useless, wasted life, or you take up practice Krishna consciousness. And when the people get these books, then they have the chance, then they get the association of Srila Prabhupada, of Krishna, like a entrance ticket to the temple with the association of all these nectarian devotees, prasadam, nectar kirtan, an entrance ticket to a spiritual life, to the spiritual world actually. Once Prabhupada said, once they even touch a book, or even if they see a devotee performing devotional service, then their spiritual life starts. I did not go out with books this marathon. I was in Switzerland because it's more relaxed there. I was selling my energy balls and I just remember about prasadam, one statement of Prabhupada that inspires me. He writes, if somebody only once accepts the remnants of the food offered to the Lord, he will come back to Krishna consciousness at one point in time or another. If somebody comes in touch with Krishna consciousness, you will come back to Krishna consciousness at one point in time or another. It may happen in this life that somehow Krishna gives him the inspiration gives them some understanding, or later. But we'll come back to Krishna consciousness means we'll become a devotee, we'll go back to Krishna. If somebody gets just a little, if somebody goes around for 4 hours and sells only, finally sells one Gita to a person who is very inspired by this, and then goes on for another 2 hours not selling anything. People who watch this person, they see the people who watch the devotees, they see the seriousness of the book distributor. They see how they endeavor despite the weather, despite the officials who want to, and so on and so forth, despite these differences, these hindrances. I mean, still they go out, and people who got a little brain left, they see it and they appreciate it, and they are impressed. They, a part of their consciousness gets infected by this Karuna virus. Most of us will know Srila Prabhupada's typewriter was of the from the company Karuna. Karuna means mercy, and somehow by, I was thinking, yeah, so many people, they now there is this virus, and they get a little frightened, and their trust in the whole system gets a little bit shaken. The book distribution was so good this year, and it is, the whole thing is Krishna's arrangement, is Krishna's mercy upon us. Srila Prabhupada made the statement some decades ago that there will be this war between East and West Bloc, capitalism and communism. And devotees asked, is there no way to avoid this? And Srila Prabhupada said, I read this yesterday, day before yesterday, if we are able to distribute so many books in the West and as also in the East, then the consciousness of the people will become infected, and the whole country will become spiritualized, so that the people are ready to give up their inimical nature. And it happened like this. Krishna sent Gorbachev, Mr. Gorbachev, become the head of state. He let the devotees free in Russia. Once he came to Berlin, and he was driving in his bulletproof car through Berlin, and the devotees, they were very thankful to him because he allowed Krishna consciousness to be practiced. He let the devotees get out of the labor camps and prisons and mental hospitals, and they were there on the side of the road making kirtan and having some signs. Gorbachev, when he drove by the devotees, he let down his window, and he put out his arm from the car and waved at the devotees, and kind of beginning of the fall of the Iron Curtain. Srila Prabhupada, one last thing, what do I have to say? Prabhupada called the books time bombs. They are spread everywhere, and they are, well, some time bombs, they are obviously, they are just waiting for some time to explode. In Russia, it was not possible for a long time. Now in every village, there are 1,000 devotees or something. And the books are everywhere, and they are infiltrating the consciousness of the people. Well, this is theory. Unfortunately, I did not go out. I hope for the future. Srila Prabhupada's transcendental books, ki jai. Srila Prabhupada's book distribution, ki jai.
Praise, it's wonderful to hear Srimati Lotus inspired to notice our book distribution, and thank you for all your blessings. Srila Prabhupada ki
jai.
Jai Ho. Yeah, it was perfect. I can't park anyway.